This is going to be a video on blinding powder implements, somewhat how to make them, what you can possibly make them out of. The first one, very simple, tissue paper. Just one simple sheet of tissue paper should do just fine. You want it to be able to rip open very easily. When you hit it against your hand, it will pop open, adding all the blinding powder in the palm of your hand so you can throw it. Okay, so after adding the amount desired of blinding powder, simply wrap it up into a little ball form. Like so. And you have something like this. You can cut this excess off, and the idea is that you would simply rip this apart and distribute as desired. The other forms of blinding powder holders or containers that you would use to distribute blinding powder are bamboo tubes. Bamboo hollow cylinders. Now, I have two different kinds here. Okay, first one, I have painted black. It is just closed. In the end, I have some wax melted in to ensure a nice airtight seal and everything. I had it, the bottom knocked out. And of course, hollow and the open mouth in the end. You would simply put your powder in, and again, with tissue paper, to make it a little bit more easier than having to pull out a tough cork and maybe even have to struggle a little bit if it's been in there for a while. Simply take some tissue paper that you really don't care about, can be ripped out and discarded, and you're ready to go. You have a nice bit in there, and you want to leave some room. You don't want to fill it all the way to the top and pack it in there, because then when you want to distribute it, it won't properly fly out. You want it to stay, you want this powder to stay loose and fluffed on the inside. Again, so when you distribute it and throw it and whip this in the direction desired, it will actually come out. And even if this sits in here for a while, you might want to give it a shake so that it stays fluffed up and again comes out when desired. Again, add your tissue paper to make sure it doesn't come out, and you're ready to go. I have, again, tissue paper as a cork with your open mouth end, but this one has a cork in the bottom that can be pulled out at the last moment, right before you whip this out and distribute the powder. This way, the airflow, when you whip this, the wind actually goes into the tube and helps push the powder out at more of a rapid rate, I find. I've tried this. It works a lot better than the closed end. Whip this, it just kind of comes out a little bit at a time. You have to give it a few whips, and it distributes evenly. With this, when you have an entire hollowed section with two open ends, you have first cork, then the second cork, then you whip. Again, the air pushes it all out at once, and it's a nice big shot of blinding powder in the direction you want. Film it and leave some room so that you can keep it shook up and fluffy, and you're ready to go. Next are the famous eggs. I have real eggs, some painted black, some regular white. Take a needle, a sewing needle, if you find, Or I have handy, already on me, a blow dart, which has a very needle sharp tip. Because what you do is scratch away at the animal until you have a spot where you can start twisting in almost in a drill-like fashion. You want to create a small hole. You want to do this on both ends. After making the first hole, flip it over. Again, scratch away at the animal, find a spot to poke or small drill the hole. You might even want to, after you have the hole drilled, you might want to just chip away a rather bigger hole so that you're ready to put the powder in, as well as when you blow the egg out, it will easily come out for you and you're not making yourself red in the face. Then, after your holes, find that larger end, because what you do, starts coming out all by itself already. You blow the entire egg out, or the entire yolk and everything out of your eggshell. Till you have a light, hollow egg. Empty. Again, what acts as a good cork or stopper is some tissue paper. Unlike the tubes where you whip it out and you still have the container, this you pretty much destroy completely. You crush it and the blinding powder is all over in your hand and you throw it. And or you can just take this and throw it directly at the face and it will smash and all over them. Or to make life a little easier, to cheat a little bit and practice this in a little bit of a modern term, I found some Easter decorational plastic eggs. They split in half in the middle. They're just plastic. And then they close up and they actually have a nice tight fit that they kind of stay intact. You can get ones of all different sizes. Okay. Makes life a little easy because you just pop these open. Dip.